Induction heater update. It's Wednesday, I think. So it's running stably. Watt meter says 870 watts, but we now don't really trust that. Delivering 52 volts at 19 amps into the upgraded heatsink circuit. IRFP 260 times 2, water and air cooled through a big bunch of capacitors, a couple of chokes, and a large coil inside which is today's experiment, which is plaster of Paris and vermiculite mixed into a sleeve, an insulating sleeve for the graphite crucible, which has got glass in it. So waiting for that to go off. Starting to go, you can sort of see in there. I'll put the lid back on. So the vermiculite, this sort of stuff, plaster of Paris, mixed in a paint tub, goes off really quickly, cut off, and now is works quite nicely with that coil. Takes its time because the size difference is so great, but it also doesn't trip itself out. And last night I put this little voltage comparator which looks at the supply voltage to the heater, and if it goes below 18 volts it trips that relay which turns off the variac. This happens when the magnetic coupling between the load and the coil gets too close, and it draws loads of amps, the MOSFETs heat up, the voltage dips, they go into spasm and usually explode. However, this little circuit has saved me, I think, 10 MOSFETs today. 10 MOSFETs! Hurrah! So, it's running quite stably. This has now been running for half an hour, 40 minutes, I suppose. Should have timed it, I guess. Still way to go on that, but there we go, hurrah!